Leg Cam exclusive.
Power 98.3, yo, live on the phone. The Bootleg Kev Show. I got the homie, Rose Rick Ross. What's up, bro?
You already know what it do, big homie. You know I had to call you and salute you.
I appreciate the call, my dude. You know, we fresh out here in Phoenix from Vegas, so, you know, I had to get the big dogs to check in with me.
You already know it's all love.
Hey, man, I got to give you a big shout-out on the Self-Made 2 album. It's damn near perfect, man, and I'm not gassing you right now. It's a great album.
Oh, man, I appreciate it, man. You know, we put a lot to it. Self-Made 2, it was released a week or two ago, and, you know, the streets responded pretty good to it, man. If you don't got it, go get it. And, you know, it's just a reflection of MMG as a unit, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, July 31st, I'm doing my thing.
God forgives, I don't.
Yeah.
Yeah, that Fountain of Youth joint is crazy, man. Everybody, you know, we on the West Coast, man. I got to know, can you please sign Nipsey Hussle, dog? Can we make that happen? I know it's a lot of rumblings about it, but we got to make that official sooner or later, dog.
Oh, man, I'm a big fan of the homie, man. And just to keep it 100, you never know. Keep your ears to the streets, man.
Yeah, that's what it is, man. Let's talk about the album dropping July 31st. Why did you decide to kind of drop the Self-Made 2 and your solo album so close to each other?
Because, man, it's just all about the movement. You know what I'm saying? If you love dope music, great music, you know what I'm saying? It's rap music. You gonna stay in the game and you're going to support both of them, Self-Made 2. And, you know, it's just show a lot of different artists doing their thing. And, of course, you know, my album, man, I just collaborated with people I was huge fans of. And, you know, such as Dr. Dre for the first time, man. Dr. Dre and Jay-Z on the same record by the name of Three Kings. Man, it's,
man,
you know, just witnessing that, being in the studio with, you know, both of them dudes, man. It was a hell of an experience, you know what I'm saying? It's just something that I could never really even see happening. So, you know, on a personal level, that was big for me. Of course, the record I did by the name of 16 featuring Andre, it's a classic.
Now, let's talk about the Andre record. It's called 16. I mean, what is the concept of the record? Because I'm
basically, not to cut you off, but basically it was just when you get, you know, some music that you really love, you know, or a track that you really love, and sometimes 16 bars is not enough to really express yourself.
Indeed.
You know what I'm saying? So we just went to that next level. And I think, you know, for people to hear Andre do what he did, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to let y'all count how many bars he did, as well as, you know, of course, what I did, man. And, you know, he pulled out the guitar and banjo on this one, and he sang a little bit at the end of it. It's like it just broke all the rules of making a standard record. You know what I'm saying?
Indeed. Were you in the studio? Because, you know, it's 2012. A lot of times, you know, you don't got to be in the same country as somebody to collaborate with them. Were you in the studio with Andre?
No. You know, he was working on an actual film. He was in one part of the country at the time. So we did a lot of Skyping and, you know, stuff.
God
like
bless
that,
technology,
man.
Right?
But better believe it.
Hey, man, let's talk about the Rocky Fresh signing, man. I've been a big fan of Rocky Fresh for a long time. I always thought he was just kind of, even in the blog scene, I always felt like he was somebody who really didn't get as much attention as a lot of other artists that are buzzing. What brought you to inking him up to the gang?
Man, I saw, I was introduced to one of his videos by the name of Enter the Future.
Great song.
He was in the video. I'm watching it, you know, I had to heard some of his music, but I never, you know, got to, you know, put, you know, a face with, you know, the voice and the name. So I just was watching his video, and, you know, I stayed up a couple nights and Googled basically all of his videos, and, you know what I'm saying?
Did your groundwork.
Yeah, most definitely. I was just a fan at that point, just loving how homie was coming across, man. He was just like, you know, he just kept everything so simple, straightforward, and just had dope lyrics and dope hooks and concepts. And, you know, I flew him out, and, you know, we kicked it, and he went back home, and, you know, of course, everything else just went to work. You know,
that's something I really respect about you, Ross. Is like, you know, you're on top right now of the game, and a lot of times, when people are on top, you get your fair share of hate. I mean, everybody gets their fair share of hate in this game, but I feel like you're one of the dudes that really preserves, like, this hip-hop game, like, you know, and you do the street thing, you do the trap stuff that, you know, you could rock, where, you know what I'm saying, at King of Diamonds, but you preserve just good hip hop. You know what I'm saying? Especially with these signings that you've been putting together. Like, I do like Stally, you know, of Rocky Fresh and Wale, you know what I'm saying? I think it's something to really commend, man. Like, the run you've been on this last 2 years has been, like, something real special for just for music, man.
Man, I appreciate it, man. And I think that just comes from me being a student of the game, you know what I'm saying? Going out and buying my vinyl as a kid, my cassette tapes. You know what I'm saying? You know, up towards my CDs, and when I see these artists such as Stally, you know, such a hip-hop purist and such a deep thinker, man, and just, you know, come across and deliver a message, as well as Wale, who I feel one of the best lyricists in the game.
Bet, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? And, you know, of course, Rocky Fresh, you know, he bringing some, you know, real dope to the game, 21 years old. You know what I'm saying? It's just real flat.
Hey, with this new album, it really hasn't seemed like you've had like a radio single take off yet. And, you know, it's coming out in 2 weeks. Is that something that kind of, you know, concerns you before the album comes out? At this point, I think you're the kind of artist where you're going to drop in. I mean, I've been waiting for this for a minute, this album, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like no matter what happens on the single side, I feel like you're going to do your numbers. But, I mean, on your side of the business, is that something that you're kind of like, you know, do you look at that? Does that bother you, or does it you just worried about getting it out?
Nah, it don't bother me at all, man. You know what I'm saying? We the hottest team in the game.
Yep.
You know, the people that support me and my fans, you know, they always been there, man, from day one in this body of work that I'm putting together. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I've never really had... with the exception of my last album, the three before that, you know, my singles and radio play, that's not nothing that I've really, you know, ran
depended on, yeah.
Yeah, so I just really did it for, you know, the streets and everybody else that know what I do, you know what I'm saying? And I'm excited. I can't wait for the album to drop.
Yeah, it seems like, I mean, just from being from a fan's perspective, you know, I remember going and copying Port of Miami when it first drops. I remember Cross That Line was my joint with Akon. That was my record. But it seems like, man, album to album, you're like, you're outdoing yourself. It's like you're getting better each, you know, with each album, it's just, you know, a better piece of body of work. I'm sure you continue that progression on this album, I'm sure.
Oh, man, most definitely. I think that's what makes, you know, a great legacy. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I'm chasing at this point. I'm saying just making dope music. You know what I'm saying? Putting my homies on, you know what I'm saying? Smoking good, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, I appreciate, I saw the, you know, the track listing, Maybach Music Ford. Usually when you drop the Maybach Musics, you know, you got a wide array of MCs on there with you, but this one is just you and Neo.
Yeah, most definitely. We did something totally different. I just went crazy on the bars. I spit maybe, you know,
you blacked out real quick?
Yeah. And then on the singing side, Neo, he did some crazy shit, you know what I'm saying? Like two totally different styles of sound on his side, you know
Damn.
What I'm saying? He sang one way, then at one point you would think it was a total different person.
Who produced the new Maybach Music record?
The Justice League.
Oh, man. See,
yeah,
that's the winning combo right there.
They produce all of the... Maybach Music, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, you know what's crazy? My favorite moment of Teflon Don was when the song breaks down in Maybach Music 3 and you come on. It's like a movie. I had goosebumps when I first heard it.
Well, if you love that kind of production and them kind of breaks,
just cinematic,
you're gonna
love
this new album, God Forgives I Don't, my brother.
Hey, man, it's out July 31st. We've been waiting on this for a long time. Ross, yo, real talk, man. Like, we in your era, you and Kanye are running shit right now. And I hope that it continues to be that way. Hip-hop is in good hands. Let's just say it like that. It ain't been in hands this good for a very long time. So,
Man, you already know. I just got to thank all my supporters, everybody that's listening. You know I love y'all. Hit me up on Twitter, at Ricky Rose. Change those Avies, GFID, MMP. We here for life. You already know, homie. You've been repping me from day one, so I salute you forever.
All day, my brother. I appreciate it, man. And, yo, we out here in Phoenix, you know, we wouldn't mind seeing that Nipsey, you know, maybe Emilio Rojas. I'm a fan of Emilio. I'm hearing all these rumors. So, you know, I know you're gonna do what's best for the team, but you know, I'm just saying what one fan myself would like to see.
You already know, man. You never know, man. Let's keep our ears to the streets and keep going.
Much love, brother.